That's eight. I just broke a rod right here.
Oh no! Son of a gun.
Oh, it's a school of them. There's five or six right here.
Oh, he just let go.
It's going to be a premier invite only kind of event and qualifier. So to make it there, like, that means you have accomplished, you know, and you're going to be fishing with the best of the best in redfish. The elite of the elites.
Come on, baby. I need it.
We're down here in Lower St. Bernard at Hope Del Marina, where boats are lining up for the first day of the Redfish World Series Tournament. We had a chance to talk to some of these guys last night to see how they're preparing for the tournament.
You know, you're here in a special place, and you're here at a really special time, because this is the Redfish World Series. So welcome to the inaugural Redfish World Series Captain's Banquet.
This tournament's unique because it's the best of the best. How do you prepare for something like this?
Well, here is different than any other state, be it the Carolinas, Florida, Alabama. Here, ounces separate first to 20th. When you get in my region in Florida, first place could be 14 pounds and 20th place could be 5 pounds. Here, it'll be 14 pounds and 20th place will be 12 pounds and a half. I mean, it's that tight. So you have to really focus on the width of the fish just as much as the length.
You know, these fish here, you can get a lot closer to them. There's a lot more ability to see them and catch them versus in Florida. If you see a fish, he's seen you 100 yards before you saw him. So, and just the techniques of catching them here, such a wide variety of techniques you can use here. We're back in Florida, where we're from. Most of the techniques here would not even work back home.
You know, you pre-fish, you find some things that look good to you. You never know on game day if the fish that you found are going to still be there. You don't want to overthink it. You know, basically, you don't worry about the other guys. You concentrate on what you can do. You see the fish, you pitch to it, you hope he eats, and hopefully you come up with the kind of weight you need to win the tournament.
This is the redfish mecca here. This is where everybody wants to come to catch redfish. It's one of the best fisheries in the country to be able to sight fish and actually catch the redfish like we want to do as tournament anglers. And it's just a blessing in disguise, and it's my hometown, so it's even better for me.
The fishing estuary here is just better than anywhere I've ever fished in my life. And you catch redfish, trout, flounder, you go out in the Gulf not far out, you just catch just about every species of fish you could ever dream of catching right here in St. Bernard. And we love coming here.
St. Bernard is one of the fisheries, is one of the, I would say, one of the best fisheries in Louisiana. Everybody has their own preference. Every time I come here, I have fun no matter what. It's all about what you bring. You know, you could actually come here and you could catch 20, 30 fish. You could come here and catch 5 fish. But no matter what, just being out there in the marsh is where it's at.
We're here with Jamie. He's from Charleston, South Carolina. He's a fisherman, but he's also a cook. Tell me a little bit about that.
I am. I'm what you would consider a home cook. I've been cooking for these guys on tour for a long time due to the Traeger Grill sponsorship. And this year I was lucky enough to be on MasterChef. And so, you know, the season just ended and I was able to get back to my passion, which is coming to South Louisiana and chasing redfish. You know, it's the redfish capital of the world, arguably. And obviously it's the festival capital of the world. So why not come down here for the Redfish Festival?
And how does competing on MasterChef compare to competing in a redfish tournament?
There's a lot of similarities, but there's a lot of differences too. You get one shot at this, and nobody cares really what you look like or what you have to say or how you cook, for instance. But you know, it's competition nonetheless. So we're looking forward to getting out there, and the way I look at this is the same way as cooking. Instead of being me against the competitors, it was me against the food. Same thing with the redfish tournament. It's me against the fish. It's not really me against the other competitors. So there's a lot of camaraderie in this group. All these guys are great guys. It's the 48 best teams in the world. I'm looking at T. Paul Dufresne right now, which is one of the best anglers on the planet. So this is going to be a good week. It's going to be a fun 4 days.
All right, Gritter, we're here for day one of the Redfish World Series. The boats took off earlier today, yep. Trying to catch, what, 2 fish it is?
Yeah, 2 fish, 27 inches. They got to get them right today.
And so you started this event last night with a dinner. Tell me about that. It was a beautiful event.
Oh, man, we had a banquet. It wasn't a dinner. We had a banquet. We showed out last night. We had a laser light show. Somebody on stage had on really shiny shoes. I think that was me. But I'm telling you, we had a big time. We showed what the parish could do. We showed what the anglers could do. We showed what this was all about. It was really, really big, and it was really fun.
Yeah, some good food served there and lots of drinks. I heard they ran out of Crown maybe.
Hey, we're not going to say that really, are we? But yeah, it did happen. It did happen, and that's okay because everybody had a great time. And it was all in preparation for this World Series event today. You know, these guys took out of here at 7 o'clock in the morning, and, you know, they're ready to go. They are fired up. This has never happened before. They're excited.
And tell us about the format, because some guys mentioned it's different than any other tournament they played in.
It is different. We made it into a 4-day format. And what we did is on this today, they're bringing 2 fish back. Then tomorrow they're going to bring 3. The next day they're going to bring 4. The next day they're going to bring 5. So we made it a progressive bag limit, and that's tough. That's really, really tough. You can be in first place on the last day when you start. You can be in last place when it's over. It's tough. They know it, I know it, and we love it.
And meanwhile, while this is going on in Hopedale, you have a whole entire festival happening back up in Chalmette. Tell me about that.
Yeah, we sure do. We got a Redfish Festival, the first and only in the entire United States of America, in St. Bernard Parish. Let me mention that. So we got great live music. We got food, bands. We got a midway rides, all the carnival food. It's going to be a really big time.
Well, we're looking forward to checking out the festival and seeing who brings home the trophy, the ring, and everything with this tournament.
Oh, yeah. When they get that big bronze trophy, that redfish and the ring and all that, come on now. $50,000 check. I want to play now, you know. So it's going to be fun.
Day one brought some good catches early on for a few of the teams.
Boys, these two I think going back with us, unless we get a little last minute heroics.
Joe Worthy and Randy Lane were the first two to weigh in after only about 3.5 hours of fishing.
1646, get out of here. Come on, guys, that's a big bag.
We're here with Joe and Randy. These guys went out at, 7 a.m. and came back at
10:45? 10:45. We came back in. We figured that we don't have a lot of fish. We're not on a lot of fish, so it's a strategy because it's 4 days of fishing. It's a game of, you know, do we go out there and catch all the fish we want today, or do we know we have over 16 pounds and we can play tomorrow and still fish those fish that we were on today?
And how many fish did you guys catch before you decided, okay, we got 2 good ones?
Well, we total today we might have caught 10 to 12 fish. We were catching good weight all day, but we needed that kicker, which was the last fish we caught. and we didn't want to beat our places up. We had to manage it. We have to manage our fishery, so because we're going to be in there every day. So we felt like we had met our goal. We actually exceeded our goal a little bit, so we're going to leave it alone and hit it again tomorrow.
Knocking Joe and Randy out of first place was local charter captain Britt Ardiz and his partner Fred Myers.
1648, holy moly, what does that do for you? First place. You gotta like that for a minute. Y'all just took over the lead, Fred.
I'm here with Britt and Fred Myers. They are now the leaders of the tournament. Tell me how today went.
I mean, as far as fishing, it was everything you can ever ask for as an angler. You know, we did have some miscues today. But I think we can clean that up tomorrow. But I mean, as far as strategy goes, we did exactly what we wanted to do. We wanted to catch some good fish today and then leave some for the rest of the week if we can make it to that fourth day.
And you guys, I heard you say you were caught what you actually just weighed in by 10 a.m. this morning. Is that correct?
Probably about 9:30. We just power pulled down in one spot and let our fish come by, sight casting them all, and just looking at them. We picked the ones out we wanted, and just let them keep coming by. And we want to be a little conservative because it's a four-day tournament, so there's a lot of strategy involved. Tomorrow's three, next day's four, next day's five. So we got to save some, and I think we got plenty.
After all the weigh-ins, South Carolina anglers Marvie Benford and Rob Cohen took the lead.
1668, a new leader. Way to go, guys. Come on.
We're here with Marvie and Rob, the new leaders in the tournament. Guys, tell me what happened today, how you guys, like, what your strategy was.
We went back to an area where we found some bigger fish pre-fishing this past week. Not a lot of fish, but the fish we found in this area were big ones. So we knew we were going to see a lot. Water's muddier where we went, but we got one big one right off the bat this morning. And another 2 hours went by, and we caught one, thought was going to be a good fish, and he went a half inch over. So it was 30 minutes left for us to fish. We were nervous and struggling. You know, you get in the last 30 minutes, and we finally saw one floating down the bank and hooked him, and he was good. So we had a tough day. I mean, we caught three or four fish today. Just fortunate to catch two good ones. So,
wow. Well, good. Congratulations on that. And what's your plan going into tomorrow? Any new strategies?
No, just kind of stick with the original game plan and beat it out. That's about all you can do.
Well, you guys are fishing with the best of the best, right?
Exactly.
So anybody can win this tournament.
A group of guys.
Yeah.
So it's tough, very tough. But when you got a partner like that, it makes it a lot better.
After day one of the tournament, the top five anglers are separated by less than half a pound, and the top two are only 0.02 of a pound away from one another. So it's anyone's game going into day two. All right, Gritter, we're here for day two of the tournament. Some guys came in yesterday with some good fish, maybe some not so good fish.
We had a couple of tragedies, sort of, kind of. Some guys made the mistake of pushing the line. They tried to push that fish up to 27. By the time they got here, it went over. One of them was literally a hair over the line.
What would be your strategy going into today?
Well, today is three fish. You know, today's a little bit different because you got to catch three and keep three alive. You want to catch, and today you push it a little bit. Today you bring that fish in, it's painting the line because you got to press to get in the gold division. You really want to be in that top 12. So today, they'll push it a little bit. We'll see some guys go over, and it'll be unfortunate, but that's the game.
Day two brought some usual suspects to the top of the leaderboard again.
22-60 for 39-08. You took over the top spot with a big number, guys.
I mean, we're feeling pretty good. There's still a lot of good teams behind us, but we had to make a crucial decision early today to bring in what we had. We still had plenty of time left to fish, but we didn't want to keep pounding on our fish. We needed to leave some for tomorrow and the next day if we make that cut. And I think we did. We did more than what we wanted to do today. We did about a pound and a half more than what we said we needed to catch.
The biggest plan for us is to be consistent. I mean, you can't. All our fish were real consistent. We had two a little over 8 pounds, and then we had one around 7 pounds. We probably could improve that fish today, but we knew that we had, since we had a lead yesterday, that carries over to today, obviously. to make the top 12. We started out with a pound and a half weight over top 12. So our goal was to make the top 12. Now we're sitting in the lead because we're fishing conservative. I'm not saying we'll be in the lead after today, but we'll definitely be in striking distance to do good, and we got fish to catch.
Well, good job, guys, and good luck for the rest of the tournament. Right, thank you. After finishing in 27th place on day one, Houma, Louisiana anglers Kevin Harvey and Lance Trahan took over first place on day two. Their three catches weighed in at 25.97 for a two-day total of 39.93.
Yesterday we moved around a good bit. We scouted for about 3 days in this area. Fish were all over the place. The water was good. Today we started back, pretty much went to the old spot we fished before, and we actually didn't catch them up until the water started falling out the marsh pretty good. And those fish kind of stacked up with all the pogie that moved in, and we capitalized, you know, at the last minute, you know.
Very good. And now you guys are at the top of the leaderboard. So any strategy going into tomorrow? You got four fish to catch tomorrow, correct?
Yeah, we're just going to start off where we left off today. I mean, the fish were there, so we're just going to go back on them and hope to catch four decent fish. You know, we're not looking for all 8-pounders. You know, if we'll be happy with 7-pounders tomorrow, you know, and that'll keep us right up where we at.
Here are the current standings. First place finishers on day one, Marvy and Rob, were knocked out of the top 12 due to incurring a 1-pound penalty. However, only 3 pounds separate first from 12th, so it's anyone's game. The wind picked up on day three, and some of the anglers found themselves struggling. Woo! First place finishers on Friday, Kevin Harvey and Lance Trahan fell to last place.
626.
Perennial powerhouse team of Britt and Fred managed to stay in second place with a total weight of 67.42. But it was local anglers Eddie Adams and Sean O'Connell who made the biggest move on day three of the tournament.
Catching all these fish are all coming up on his side, by the way. I just want you guys to know that.
They need 30 pounds to get there, and they've got 31.85. There's your new leaders, Eddie Adams and Sean O'Connell. Good job, man. Way to go. All right. Wait, hold on.
I'm here with Sean and Eddie, our leaders for today after day three. They brought in over 31 pounds, is that correct?
That is correct. Actually, 31.85, so pretty good bag to say the least. I think we got everybody by, heaviest bag was about 30, but we got most of the guys about 3-4 pounds. It's pretty good.
And how did you guys manage to pull that off?
Oh, my partner had a heavy stick today. He saw these fish. He put the bait on them. We had one of the most incredible things I've ever seen. The fish literally ate his bait. He set the hook. Hook came out. Fish nose down, was still looking, didn't take off. He put it right back and the fish ate. You know, a lot of luck in this, a lot of skill. Eddie's a skillful fisherman, but a little bit of luck goes a long way in these tournaments, especially with all these fish we're catching.
Yeah, tell me about
it. I mean, we had a really good day. I mean, we caught two really big fish, biggest fish we caught so far in the last 3 days. And I mean, the interesting format, it's a 2-fish, 3-fish, 4-fish, and 5-fish tomorrow. So it's still open. Anybody can win tomorrow still, having to bring in 5 fish. You can really have opportunity to catch up weight or make ground gain. So it's definitely going to be anybody's game tomorrow.
Anybody's game is right. These 24 anglers have a chance at winning the $50,000 grand prize. On day four, the competitors weighed in at the Redfish Festival in true Mardi Gras parade fashion.
In the house, throwing bait and hats. Team Power Pole, Fred Myers and Britt.
Each competitor was challenged with bringing in 5 fish. Unfortunately, Britt and Fred only caught 3 fish, knocking them towards the bottom of the leaderboard.
We gave it all we got. We had a good day. We missed a couple fish, but we just couldn't get through the overs. Fish too big. And this is a game you play. All I can say is we just, somebody said it better than I can say it today, but our well ran dry.
The final team to weigh in was Eddie Adams and Sean O'Connell. Could they hold on to first place?
Okay, we're good to go. Here comes the Redfish World Champion. They need 31-1-1. 33-32, there's your champions of the world right there. Yeah! That's what I'm talking about. Champion of the world.
Woo!
102 pounds. We got a world champion. Eddie Adams and Sean O'Connor. Come on, man, let's go out here. What? That's right.